Disney's Mona Lisa to Disney's The Lion King. We've all experienced great art, those moments when we know we're in the presence of genius. But where does that talent come from? Are we born with it? Or is it possible to cultivate greatness? At Sheldon's Art Academy, we prove to our students every day that dedicated professional training can awaken their inner genius and guide them towards the career of their dreams. And now, for the first time ever, you too can receive the same world-class education from anywhere on the planet. Introducing the Portfolio Art School, a revolutionary new online academy for mastering visual communication. Visual communication is the language that all artists speak. It's a toolbox of fundamental skills that you can use to create anything, from beautiful watercolor to a Hollywood blockbuster to even a skyscraper. Visual communication is used by scientists, engineers, architects, inventors, educators, and countless other professionals every day to convey their ideas. It is truly a universal language that, like math, transcends words and culture. Sheldon Borenstein is a master draftsman, a drawing teacher, and a pioneer in the field of visual communication. Sheldon has taught art for over 20 years, both here at his private studio and at prestigious universities worldwide. He enjoyed a long career as an animator at major Hollywood studios and is the author of several instructional books, including his bestseller, It Book. His students go on to work for companies like Disney, DreamWorks, Pixar, and Google, enjoying successful careers in animation, design, illustration, fashion, film, advertising, and more. So Sheldon, what do you mean by visual communication?
Visual communication consists of three core components. It is drawing, painting, and design. The three areas that have never changed throughout our history. And has always been taught to everybody who has worked in art since the caveman time through the Renaissance to current to the digital. Drawing is narrative and story. Who is this person? What are they all about? Their shape, their form, their anatomy, structure, perspective, painting, value, and color, and design, how it all works together. And we see design everywhere we go, from billboards to ads to the web, everywhere is design. But another real important part of why we say visual communication, it is the answer to a negative impact word. Moms, don't let your children grow up to be artists. Art is a negative impact word. But every corporation needs to be communicated visually. Think about it. From the moment a concept is thought of by an entrepreneur, it has to be communicated visually. You see? So every corporation needs the visual communicator.
How is this concept different from what other art schools teach?
We focus primarily on the fundamentals. It's really interesting. So many schools, so many people say, I want to do advanced work. Well, truly, what is advanced work? Advanced is advanced fundamentals. It's how you piece it together. A great cook, it's the same ingredients, they just do it right. How do you place it together? So if we teach solid fundamentals, we really do get solid animation, solid storyboard, solid illustration, all the way into the digital. It's all just made up of a few very well thought of foundations. Interesting thing is, we study those fundamentals every day.
What if a student comes to you and they're not a natural artist, like me? I can't draw for the life of me.
Talent, in our opinion, is a myth.
Really?
It's really desire. If you come to us and you have, let's say, perceived talent, but not the desire, there's not a lot we can really do. But if you come to us with this incredible desire, the wanting, we just have to teach you. I always say that really, knowledge is the door. We open the door to allow the talent out. So by giving you the knowledge, then the perceived talent explodes. Now, an artist is somebody who has a certain sensitivity for tone, a sensitivity for color. But we don't know that until we get the fundamentals.
Okay.
You see? As soon as the fundamentals happen, then all of a sudden they say, wow, look what I can do with my color. Visual communication is really visual thinking. It's a visual thought process. Research has shown that if you can get somebody to visually see themselves making a sale or visually see themselves running down the court, then it happens. So we are visual. And many people come in here and study, from doctors to kids who are going into the sciences or going into business, and they study here, never planning on working in the true film industry, video game industry, advertising industry. But it certainly helps. But not everything is just visual communication. This has criterion that must be followed. It is vetted and it will be tested. When you get a job in a studio, they put you in a testing room and they test you and they time you. Let us start you at the beginning so that you can see your success and see your dream. Our goal is that everybody get to live their dream as I and my peers and my friends have lived their dream. It's payback time.
So what made you want to start the online school?
A lot of it was from popular demand. I teach at 2 universities. We have our brick and mortar location. We get a lot of emails, a lot of phone calls saying, we are not in the metropolitan areas. We're located here in the middle where we don't get a lot of these opportunities. How can we have these opportunities? Well, in the past, it was very difficult. But now, through the web and through technology, we can actually put it right in your home, right at your computer, and you can also study it at your own pace, which really allows us the ability to teach you at a more advanced level. Because a student in a classroom will max out at a certain point. But the student working out of their home could actually stop the class, digest the information, and then come back. They will actually have a better opportunity than in the classroom. And they will also have accessibility to us. One of the questions I ask when people study online is, who's telling you what courses to take at what time? You can't run 20 miles unless you've run your first mile. Simple. So why are you taking these advanced courses when you haven't taken the courses prior? In our program, you are guided through counseling. Even if you're not sending in your work, even if you're not communicating, you are still being counseled and following the 3-tier level. Level 1, foundations. Level 2, how those foundations apply to your area of passion. And number 3, thesis level. We are actually doing work at a level of industry. So you get to follow an actual university process that you have counseling.
That's awesome.
Our goal is that a student who is not in the metropolitan, not located in that area, can get that same kind of quality education that up until just a short amount of time ago was only available in a studio. Mm-hmm. This is an actual studio training program. Congratulations, you're in. Now let's train you.
Okay, so where do your techniques come from?
The Renaissance.
The Renaissance.
Not a lot has changed since the Renaissance. It was at that time when the pre-Renaissance became the Renaissance and then the Baroque. Pre-Renaissance was kind of flat, very designy. But it was during that Renaissance when we got perspective and we were really telling stories. Those guys were pretty good. Mm-hmm. The Michelangelos, the Rubens, they were actually pretty good. And when you look at today, and even when you look at the technology of today and the latest computer programs, bam, right to the Renaissance. Same thing, okay. Same tools.
I have a quick question. Mm-hmm. What is this symbol? And why is it the logo for your school?
Well, we call this Cal State Cool for a very simple reason. It's cool. I taught in the Cal State system, and I wanted them to remember, because this is everything.
This is everything.
This
Why is
this
everything?
Everything? It's opposing curves. It's how nature is designed. It's how muscles work, flexors and extensors. It's how we design. It's how we guide the viewer's eye. If you notice here, it's like a pinball machine We actually, as visual communicators, tell the viewer where to look, how long to look, and when to look in other areas by the use of these opposing curves. Also, Cal State Cool is easy to remember. Opposing curves sounded kind of educational. Yeah, we like to have fun. We keep it fun. We sing, we dance, we tell stories, we make it silly. And through that, it really allows the student to learn faster.
Well, my initial goal was just to come in and try it out. And that's what everyone's first goal should be. If you have an interest or desire to move forward in art, you should learn the fundamentals with someone like Sheldon, someone who knows what he's doing, and just try it out, because you'll never know unless you try. And in this case, you'll never move forward unless you give something a chance. And if you like art, by all means, try our school, because it will take you to the next step and lead you to a possible career that you've always wanted.
Automatically, I knew that this is what I've been looking for. I mean, I could go at my own pace, and they suggest their own pace, and you know, it just clicked automatically. I mean, I discovered it to be like what I was missing, what I needed to advance my career and my life.
Here, you get taught the fundamentals, so it's just the building blocks to anything you want to do. So I feel like I'm prepared a lot more than I was if I just didn't take this class.
Right, yeah, you can get prepared for anything that you want to do here.
I've taken some art classes at colleges and whatnot, and I've always felt that it was missing something. And when I came here, the fundamentals are what really grabbed me about this place, because it gives you a procedure to kind of express your creativity. And when you learn it, you can look at you know, the Renaissance art, and you see where, you know, what you're learning, where it came from, and for me, that's really nice. I'd like to take it to, you know, work some sort of visual development, maybe in movies, maybe in video games, and see where it goes.
I was like every high school student, you know, wanting to figure out what they wanted to do, going to college, you know, get out, be successful, and I stumbled upon Sheldon's Art Academy online. Found my way to Portfolio Art School, and I realized that I had a place now to learn. And I, you know, watched a couple videos and just the intro videos, and it really spoke to me. I really wanted to go into video games, and I didn't know how I was going to do it. I didn't know if I could write. I didn't know if I was going to have to, you know, produce or do something like that. But art really opened a lot of doors for me.
Oftentimes people come up to me and other artists, and they always look at the work that you're doing and they ask, what tool are you using? What brand is that? Is it charcoal? Is it watercolor? So I thought, maybe it's time to go back to the golden years of the Renaissance, to the true art tools, the ones that made everybody famous. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, this is a tool that has withstood its time over the last 500 years. Ladies and gentlemen, the dark chocolate candy bar. It comes a little squashed, but you'll notice that you have a sharp edge and a round edge. It's very important. And it's also important that we work with dark chocolate because of the archival quality and pigmentation. So what we want to do is we want to start with the Cal State Cool. The Cal State Cool is the true rhythm. It's also important to do this very quickly, because if you are an artist who thinks you're kind of hot, you're going to be melting the candy bar. So there's our story, going from the nose straight down to our weight. Now, let me give you a little advice. One of the things you do not want to do is draw with a peanut butter cup, because once you get past the outer chocolate, it can get pretty nasty. Wrap around, rib cage, pelvis. Let the chocolate show you where the gluteal band is as we move down to the leg. and it melts. Bottom line, it's not the tool. It's the knowledge behind. If we're relying on the tool, we're always going to be in trouble. Let's get serious for a moment. Many of you want to go to art schools. Many of you want to go to art colleges. Most of them are solid in foundation. Some of them might not have as strong foundations as you would like. Let's make sure you walk in with those fundamentals. Let's make sure you get a little step ahead. Let's make sure you have the ability to reach your goals and have your dreams. So if we can help you get those foundations early, so then you can start focusing on your field of emphasis, you'll be solid. As my teacher always said to me, don't tell them I taught you this. Let them think you're a genius. Fundamentals, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you for your time. We'll see you soon.